Were you forced into the car with Mr. Clifford before he died?
Yes, sir.
Did you and Mr. Clifford have a conversation?
Yes, sir.
Listen up. Did Mr. Clifford mention Barry Maldonado or Senator Boyd Boyette? You answer the question, Mark.
Is taking the Fifth Amendment lying?
No, it's not lying.
Well, can I take the Fifth Amendment?
No, you cannot.
Why not? It applies to kids, doesn't it?
Not in this case, Mark. You're not implicated in the death of Senator Boyette, so you'll have to answer the question.
Your Honor, as Mr. Foltrick has done so thorough a job in attempting to implicate Mark, I must, out of an abundance of caution, advise my client to take the Fifth.
Haven't we played enough games here? Your Honor, we are all searchers for the truth. A man has been murdered, and another man lies dead by his own hand, yet this boy remains silent. What wanton hubris is this? Speak, child, now. Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord. So saith the psalm.
That's Proverbs 12:22. This is still a courtroom, not a church, Mr. Foltrick. Please sit down.
Romy Clifford tell you where Boyd Boyette's body's at, son.
Mr. Foltrick.
Yes, sir.
Answer the question, Mark.
Take the Fifth Amendment. I'm sorry, but I can't answer any of these questions because I'm afraid of what might happen to me or my family.
I have no choice but to return you to protective custody.
Come on,
you
gotta get it. All right, this isn't over yet.
Sorry, Mark, it's for your own protection.
Judge, why can't you get him to answer the question?
These proceedings are closed.
I didn't lie, Reggie.
You did great.
What kind of a lawyer tells an 11-year-old child to plead the Fifth, send him back to jail for another night and hold up a federal investigation? You trying to ruin this boy's life or just flat out get him killed?